Really, I'm honored and privileged to be amongst this August gathering for the graduation day of 2021. I first would like to thank our founder chairman, Dr. D.K. Adhikeshulu, and chairperson, Mrs. D.A. Satyaprabha, for the opportunity given to all of us to be here today. And first and foremost, I would like to welcome the parents of the proud graduates today, the guardians, the teachers, the members of your families, and all who have been responsible for you all graduates to be today with the proud hats around you and with certificates that you would be going out. I welcome you all immensely. Today is a very auspicious day and a very happy day for Vaidehi family. We have the great son of Karnataka, Dr. C.N. Manjunath, amongst us, who is going to deliver your graduation speech. He has changed the world, I would say, 100. Today I was just talking to him and he came upon 100 cardiologists under one campus. Nowhere in the country or in the world we would ever hear. He's going to give you all. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation and for being here. We have our trustee, Sri Kalala Ranganatham. He is the backbone for us after our late chairman. He is also on the advisory board of Andhra Pradesh government on energy. A very well-learned person who guides us, who has been with us all along. And today you see we have come to this as being a part of his achievement too. Thank you, sir. We have our, I welcome our trustee, Srimati D.A. Tejeshwari here, for being here from inception. She is a silent supporter of the Vaidehi family. Please give her a great welcome, please. I also welcome our principal and Dean of Vaidehi Institute of Medical Sciences, Dr. Prabhakar. Our Principal of Dental Sciences, Dr. Mohan Thomas Nainan. Our Principal of Nursing College, our Principal of Allied Sciences, Dr. Fayaz Ahmad Sattar. Now, this is equally a special day. Of course, again, for the parents, guardians, siblings, and other family members whose support made all this today possible. And most important of all, let us not forget the teachers who taught you, who came up with exciting ways to share their vast wisdom experience with you. Now the journey you embarked on is not going to be without any failures or disappointments. That's just the way life is. But you wouldn't be here with your degrees if you're not ready. So the best I could give you today is a few of my own personal ideas or experiences. I was always called too intense and to do the best. I took it literally in everything seriously. My family tells me sometimes, please take a chill pill. So this intensity always paid me off. This commitment always rewarded me. I would always say, trust yourself. And by that, what I mean is, so many of them, your parents, your teachers, everyone around you, will be advising you. But what is important for you is to dig deep and ask yourself, who do you trust? Who you want to be with? What do you want to do? So trust yourself, no matter how and what anyone else thinks. Break the rules. I know you must be thinking, what is this, break the rules? It is impossible to be a champion or a true original if you're too well behaved. You have to think out of the box. That's what I believe, because there is an excellent example we have. Our founder chairman, he was a mechanical engineer who came out of his shell and became a great business entrepreneur, an accomplished politician and philanthropist, and educationist par excellence, which we all are witnessing today. His results and his efforts today is all because he dared to think out of the box and out of his comfort zone. Don't be afraid to fail. My dear graduates, this is very important. Anything you attempt and you're not sure would pass and always win. But I was not afraid of making decisions. So dear graduates, don't be paralyzed by fear of failure, or you will never push yourself. Keep pushing because you believe in yourself, and move towards your vision, and for sure success will come. Don't listen to naysayers. This can't happen. It will not happen. It cannot be done. Just the other day, I was reading a book by Eunice Kennedy Shrivers, if people know who she is. She wanted to start Special Olympics back in 1968. Everybody in the world spoke up. It's not possible. How can people with mental disabilities and physical disabilities out of their institutions, they cannot participate in sports, in jumping, in swimming, in running, or they'll drown in the pool. There was so much of, you know, obstacles for her, but she still made it happen. And today, you see, Special Olympics is something that people look for. And after 52 years later, Special Olympics is one of the greatest organizations, and it is representing 164 countries just because one woman thought it is possible for this population to participate. So never quit. Please keep your options open. Work hard. You never want to fail because you did not work hard enough. They say, no pain, no gain. I agree. It is very important to have fun in life. But remember, when you're out there partying and enjoying, someone out there is working hard, someone is getting smarter, and someone is winning. But if you want to win, there is absolutely no way around hard work. And please always remember, you cannot climb a ladder with your hands in your pockets. So, I would like to leave you with one final thought. You must all be saying, okay, suddenly, my God, she's done. Through it all, this institute, remember, has stood tall and preserved. We are stronger and prosperous than ever before, because that is what we have always done. Our immense fighting spirit, our refusal to give up and overcome all odds. So once again, I would like to request graduates to give a roaring applause to your teachers, parents, to all that have endured you, and also yourself. Please give yourself for being here and achieved what you did. So my dear graduates, never lose that optimism and that fighting spirit. Never lose the spirit of Vaidehi, because remember, you are Vaideheans, proud, strong, and ready to soar. Congratulations, and God bless you all.